fall to the ground. Make sure the whole world feel it. That's
them gyal a red eye, never make right. Me they a suffer life, them a get by. Never bow for the fame, no? Heads high. The back of me so all them a see a tear light. Been a real from the ghetto. I ain't never gon' switch, that's facts though. Can't get me out like stain. Come a grow tough, I'ma know pain. Haters talk with a bad tongue. Can't break me, Tweedledee so dumb. I'ma be a giant thief, 5-4 from doing it so big like Drake, I'm on one. My big box got me feeling so bossy. Like Lauren Hill, me I kill them softly. This a girl rather fi be called a naughty. Cause if my too loyal, then it's gon' cost me. And
that's how I feel.
Yeah.
That's how I'm feeling.
That's how I feel.
Dog, that's just how I'm feeling. When I touch down, I'ma burn it all to the ground. Make sure the whole world feel it. That's just how I'm feeling. Big boss, I'm a big boss. Up north, brick rocks. I got the pump that'll make you jump. Don't you ever get it crisscross. Don't you ever get it crisscross. Don't you ever get it crisscross. I got the pump that'll make you jump. Don't you ever get it crisscross. Bet against me, that's a big love. You about to find out what the call. I find, then I get low. Lift off, it ain't nothing to cut the off. Stop frying, don't let it get soft. Covered in yo, in yo. Wonder why I got the whole world pissed off. That's how I'm feeling. Dog, that's just how I'm feeling. When I touch down, I'ma burn it all to the ground. Make sure the whole world feel it. That's just how I'm feeling.
He has tried me. I shall come forth as pure gold. Have you been tried in the fire? Have you been tried in the fire? Well, tell me, did you come through as pure gold?
You kick it like the benefactor's benefactor. Well, truthfully, we know you never been a factor. Well, honestly, the truth is that you've been an actor. And now your actions got them boys about to mass up. Lectures from the devil got you piping hot. This up and you get screwed and chopped, no Michael Watts. When I was 10, I knew I should have been on rap a lot. Think like that.
Look, I played the game, I missed a shot. I had the answer, then forgot. I knew one day my pop finance for not, my not, my not. For lexing, I fell out and cut the check. My not, my not. Paralyzed the set, but I been taking hits like I can die like innocent. Morning of the day, the dawn of the dead day. I don't see nothing but red. I gather the blankets and milk and the bread. I come from the east and I'm traveling west. Got a machete, I chop and I chop it. The nigga, the server, determined, the plot and the threats. It ain't no stopping a run. Popping son of God, dropping anybody who next. I want a mansion, I got a million advances. I'm gonna stay in Atlanta. Most of them move to LA and throw all of their money away and move back with their parents. I see the canvas, I got the brush in my hand. The colors are mixing again, grabbing a stick with my hand. I drop my guts, the world is us. So what? Who wanna touch? Who wanna rough me up?
Nobody.
My head is ready to bust. Kicking the dough when I come at the cut. What? Yeah. Who wanna touch? Who wanna rough me up?
Nobody.
My head is ready to bust. Do what I do and I say what I want. What? Yeah, mommy, your kid in the magazine, kid in the magazine. I had a stack on my jacket at Grammy. We see the audacity. I was a bad kid, bad city. You see the duality. Who tryna battle me, huh? Hitters is after me, and I be dabbing you. Who wanna fuck me up? Fatality, really, it's up, it's up, undoubtedly. Baby gon' touch the bucks. My salary double, your baby daddy maybe triple. I'm trouble, I get the tackle and the pick.
Tonight, it's Madden NFL football. Super Bowl 59. the Atlanta Falcons taking on the Pittsburgh Steelers.
We are pleased, as always, to be bringing you coverage of the National Football League on EA Sports. Tonight, it's all on the line. We play for the Lombardi Trophy, as it'll be the Pittsburgh Steelers, the AFC champion, taking on the champions from the NFC, the Atlanta Falcons. Brandon Gordon along with Charles Davis, and what a season it's been for our AFC champions. I mean, this was a fight just to get to the Super Bowl. You got to figure that they are very battle-tested and ready.
I'd agree with you 100% about that. You don't get there without having those types of attributes, and that's what you look for in a Super Bowl team. Character, confidence. These guys don't lack for either one of those. Now they're here. Now they're ready to win.
Meanwhile, our NFC champions, they have gone through a lot to get where they are. Everybody knows their story this season. What's the key for them as they start this Super Bowl?
Let's go full cliche on this one because it works. Remember what got you here. Been a winning formula all season long. This is a team that when we saw them in the preseason, we said they look like a group that has what it takes to be a Super Bowl winning team. And we've been proven right by what we've seen throughout the season.
It's finally time for the main event here in 2025. Away we go in Super Bowl 59. Fielded just outside the goal line. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. So here are the Steelers now to take over for the first time. And they will be led out by their 6'4 quarterback.
And he's been sensational all season long, but he saved his best work for the playoffs, leading his guys to the AFC Championship a couple of weeks ago. And now he knows what lies ahead. He's going to need to play a near-perfect four quarters of football to get his guys to the finish line.
First down, Rose. That ball caught by the former Toledo Rocket, Deontay Johnson. And in for the Steelers' touchdown. Deontay Johnson with a first touchdown of this Super Bowl and a long one at that. And the Steelers are on the board first here in this Super Bowl.
Brandon, this is the Super Bowl. A touchdown scored in any game is big. In this one, it's massive.
On here, Brandon McManus for the point after. And he'll put it through to make it 7-0 Steelers. Scoring summary, 3-play drive, and it ends with a Pittsburgh touchdown. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. Taken in at the 3. And he'll get it up just past the 20 as his guys will go to work at the 21-yard line. So here come the Falcons now to get the football for the first time. They'll be led out by their quarterback, a product of NC State. It's Jacoby Brissett.
And he comes in off of a tremendous game in the NFC Championship round 2 weeks ago. This has been a team all season long that's really taken their identity from their quarterback, and he's been very vocal in days leading up to this game that he believes that this is their time, and he's going to do all he can to will them to a Super Bowl win.
And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. Defense. So they will accept the penalty and move forward. So now a fresh set of downs, first and 10 after roughing the passer. On play action, Brissett. Oh, into a sea of defenders and intercepted. Picked off at the 48. And a return across midfield and to the 46-yard line. They could not ask for a worse start. You give up a touchdown on the game's opening drive, and then you turn right around and throw the interception on your very first play.
And this is where the coaching staff has to earn its money, because they've got to calm these guys down a little bit. Just as you noted, a horrendous start both sides of the ball. But now the defense, which gave up an opening drive touchdown, they've got to go out there now and start playing like the team they want to be.
Throwing on first down, Rose. 3 yards the gain there, second down. Back to throw, Rose. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm, incomplete. Now it's third down. On third down, Rose. He finds his man, complete. That's ball. And he will have a Steelers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. And CD, one of the big stories everybody's been tracking this week, the head coach of this offense, looking to become just the second coach in NFL history to win 5 Super Bowl titles.
And let's face it, the respect is there already. We know he's going to go down as one of the all-time great coaches. But even after all this success, what do we notice most about him? He never takes anything for granted. He's treating this Super Bowl like it's the most important game ever played, because for some of the guys on his team, it will be. And he feels the same way himself. I love his intensity. I love the way he gets his team prepared to play in the big game.
Now a pass that's taken in by Smith-Schuster. They get him to the ground right on the cusp of the red zone after a pickup of 5 or 6. For the Falcons, 5 men in the secondary, now on third. Looking to throw, Rose. He finds his man, complete. It's ball. And he will have a Steelers first down, and he'll have it by plenty as they're able to keep the drive alive on 3rd and inches.
There are a lot of tough routes to try and cover. When you see a runner come out of the backfield and run this angle route, looks like they're going to the flat, and then they put their foot in the ground and cut back sharply inside, not easily covered, and then when they catch it, good momentum built up by them as well.
And able to pick up the first. And a quick throw here, that's complete. A gain of 6 there on first. To go on 2nd down from the 7. And a little bit of space there, takes it inside the 5 to the 3. This will be play number 8 here on the drive. It's 3rd and 1 yard. Back to throw. Rose got his man. It's caught for a Steelers touchdown. A great effort there to make the grab. And the Steelers will add to their first quarter lead here in this Super Bowl. They've got to be thrilled on the road right now. Touchdown, turnover, touchdown, and quickly trying to make it 14-0.
Yeah, mentioned it already. On the road, to be able to go into someone else's house and establish a start like that, obviously your confidence rises in a big way, and you're putting some doubt in their minds.
McManus's point after is good, and that'll make the score 14-0. So that drive consumes 9 plays all told, and it ends with the Steelers finding the end zone. leads the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. On the return, Deontay Harris. And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27. Out comes this field general once more, leading his offense back onto the field. And he'll need to find a way to shrug off the opening drive, if you can even call it a drive. One play and an interception, so he's got to forget that.
I know that in today's football, we have a good number of coaches who don't look at time of possession the way that the old school guys did, but there's still a place for it. And I think that on this drive, after having thrown that interception, they're going to want to eat up a little bit more clock and run some offense and give their defense a little bit of a break.
Throwing again on second down. Brissett, he finds his man, complete. That's Brooks. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. First carry now for Kareem Hunt. And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 41. It's a loss of four on the first down play.
Came out in a power set, but that only served to put more men in the box. And guess what? If you're going to do that, you've got to win up front, right? Your offensive guys have got to beat the defenders. They lost all leverage on that play.
So still 14 yards to go, second down. Throwing, Brissett. That's into the hands of Pitts, the tight end. They get 11 back on that one. It leads to third down. Play fake, Brissett. It's brought in by Harris. And he's going to have a Falcons first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. So first and 10 now from the 30. From the shotgun, it's Brissett. He gets it complete to Harris. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. A give right side now to Hunt. And they go the wrong way here. Knocked back to the 20. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Well, it's almost football 101 that you preach to your safeties. Don't let anyone get behind you. You're the last line of defense. But he didn't let the play come to him. He went to the play. How about that read and recognition and finishing off that one behind the line of scrimmage?
A rare misstep on that last play because the drive has been strong, but now it's second and 12. A carry here for Hunt. And he'll get this one down to about the 17. Eighth play of the drive forthcoming, and they need 8 yards on third down. Here's Brissett. And he's going to go down. They sack him back right around the 30. The defense rising to the challenge and setting him back on the sack.
It's about how teams are so competitively matched and you just want to make those plays that give you an advantage. How about right here? The difference between letting them score a touchdown versus holding them to a field goal, that's absolutely huge with the play he just made.
And you know he hated taking the loss there on third down. So out now comes the field goal unit for the Falcons. It'll come from the right hash. It's a 47-yard attempt. Blankenship's kick is good. And they will get themselves on the board here at 14-3. To So in the end, they had the ball for 10 plays, but the drive gets them 3, not 6.
Is it okay if I give credit to both sides on this one?
Absolutely.
All right, let's start defensively. They hung in there. 10-play drive, but they stiffened when they got close to the goal line, made them kick a field goal. For the offense, 10-play drive. They might be a little disappointed they got a field goal, but they moved the ball down the field with dispatch and came away with points.
And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. Now, right now, they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. 2 drives, 2 touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
They'll run on first down. Ball. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about 4. 2nd and 6. Following the pickup of 4, here's 2nd and 6. Off play action. Rose. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
As a defensive back, you have some weapons at your disposal that we don't often talk about. And you can read the receiver's eyes, you can read his hands, and you know that the arrival of the ball is imminent. And that allows you to make a play on it and oftentimes knock it away.
To throw on 3rd down, Rose. That is caught by Smith-Schuster. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on 3rd down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot. And they connected there and picked up a 1st down.
On 1st and 10, Rose. And his throw is incomplete.
I didn't like the look of that play right from the beginning. I thought he should have seen the coverage that was there, tried to force it in. That one, he's fortunate, just fell incomplete.
2nd and 10. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. They get 6. That'll leave them with 3rd and 4. Again, he'll drop to throw. He finds his man complete. It's ball. And he will have a Steelers 1st down as he'll be marked down 1 or 2 past the marker following a gain of 6. A pretty sizable deficit here in the 1st quarter. This defense probably need to get off the field in those situations on 3rd down.
And you and I both know in this huddle before that last 3rd down play, that's exactly what they talked about. Let's make a play. Let's get off the field. Let's reverse the momentum. Instead, they got hit with another 1st down, almost back to the drawing board.
Back to throw again. He finds his man complete. It's sharp. And able to break 1 tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. Options galore here. 2nd and a few inches. They'll try the left side. Sharp. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line.
That's a good, nice, crisp run for a 1st down. I wonder if the defense might have been loosened up a little bit, maybe anticipating a pass instead of the run that they got.
They'll try and run for it on 1st and goal. Pushing and fighting his way in for a Steeler touchdown. An 8-yard touchdown run. And the Steelers are feeling good as they extend their lead in this Super Bowl.
Well, Brandon, if we go back to our meeting with the offensive coordinator, he showed us his script. Didn't show us everything now. He said, here's the script for the game. I think everything's going according to plan in a big way. 3 drives, 3 touchdowns.
Yeah, that's about as good as, that is as good as you can do, I guess. So, well done.
Yeah, well done indeed. Tremendous execution.
Extra point from McManus is good. And the lead is up to 18 now. A good drive that time as they go 9 plays in all. And the capper that put it in the end zone, a run of 8 yards. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Here's Harris to return it. And out a little across the 25 to the 27. Atlanta regains possession of the football. They trail early on in this Super Bowl as they come up first and 10. To throw, Brissett. He's got his pass catching tight end. That's Pitts. To throw again on second down, Brissett. That's going to be caught by Pitts. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds.
Well, a lot of credit to the play caller here. He saw the design in his mind and implemented it. A little zone stretcher here because they started the tight end on the left side of the formation and sent him on a crossing route. And this works really well when you can find that space between levels, and they were able to do so for good yardage.
Operating out of Steeler territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 47. On first down, they'll run with Hunt. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. To three is your score after one. So after the loss of a yard, they'll look to push forward here on second down and 11. Brissett. And the Steeler pressure too much here. He's going to go down. Stephon Tuitt. What a play by him. That's going to go as a loss of 13. Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. Brissett now. And he's got his big tight end here. It'll be a gain of 8, but it'll also lead to a fourth down.
We always hear from coaches how much they like to run crossing routes because they want to hit their receivers on the go, get them the ball, and keep them moving. How about when you hit a tight end that way? Okay, the receivers are going to run past you most of the time. Tight end, they can do their damage a different way. Break a few tackles and really scatter some people, can't they?
On fourth down, here's Jamie Gillen on to punt. And no one there to stop it. Hits at the 8, but it carries all the way into the end zone for a touchback. Now out comes their leader and the captain of this offense back onto the field. And he's been good. Two first half touchdown passes, no interceptions so far.
Does a lot for your confidence, does a great deal for your team, gives them a lead, and they're feeling really good about how they're playing. I think he expects to throw at least another one.
I was going to say, now he wants the first half hat trick, doesn't he?
Oh, without a doubt. Go ahead and fling him on the field, folks. He wants that type of celebration.
They'll contain him to just 4, second down. They'll try the left side. Ball. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line.
Any team that runs the toss and runs it successfully, that means they win the battle on the edges. That means you seal the edge in order to let your back get to the corner. They got it done there for a very nice game.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Off the play fake. Rose. Throw left side complete. That's ball. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. On first down, it's ball. And he's over midfield and into Falcon territory. Second and two. And they'll run on the inside handoff. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. But they were going draw play there. The defense wasn't fooled. They sniffed it out.
I think they're going to have to go back and take a few more acting classes, because that's what a lot of that is. You've got to influence them to think that it's going to be a pass play and have them drop out and maybe the defensive front coming forward and find yourself some space. In this case, no one was fooled and ended up spilling that play pretty well.
That is caught. It's Williams. And into the end zone. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. Preston Williams, 43 yards. And the Steelers continue to look good here in the first half of this Super Bowl.
I think if you pulled defensive backs, they would say the corner route, take that out, make it illegal, because that is so hard to recognize and so hard to adjust, because your first move is to not get beat in the middle of the field. And that's how they move you first before they break off to the corner.
But then as the wide receiver, great job. It's tough to turn those upfield and go, but he did a great job with it there.
Really good balance, really good body control, and how about the end result? A touchdown.
McManus's point after is good, and a route is on here in this first half. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. Here comes Deontay Harris from his end zone. And he returns this to the 22. Kareem Hunt and the rest of the offense making their way back out there. He's just been looking for some space. You know, I'm not going to pin it on him or the offensive line, but they need to get this run game going better.
Sometimes you just have to credit the defense. They came in with a plan themselves. So I think now you try and mix things up a little bit. Get the ball in the hands of some other people, find some other playmakers, but always let the defense believe that he's still a threat.
I was going to say, don't forget about it.
No, don't take him totally out of the game. When you're struggling on offense, you're looking for anything possible to get you going. Sometimes you do it like basketball teams that don't normally press. You put a press on, bring people to life, make them move a little bit quicker. Maybe that'll help them as they head towards the half.
So quickly all the way up at the 40-yard line. Now Brissett. Throw over the middle, going to be caught here by Pitts. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Here's Brissett. Throw right side, caught by Ridley. And a 5-yard gain gets him to the 42. Looking to throw again on second down. Brissett, he finds his man, complete. It's Harris. And he's dropped right at the 40. Gain of 3. The Falcons on third down. Just 1 for 3 thus far. Here it's 3rd and 2. They'll try to run for the first down with Hunt. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. He needed 2. He got 1. And that's going to leave him with 4th down and 1 yard.
The passing game's been working quite well so far, but the running game's been a little bit of a struggle. That's a surprise to me. Typically, when you can throw it, you've opened up lanes for your runners.
Boy, a call like this, certainly tougher to make in a Super Bowl, but they'll go for it on fourth down. Running with Hunt here out of the shotgun. And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. They run right side with Hunt. Fighting his way down to about the 35-yard line. The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight. Brissett. His throw incomplete. So third down now. They need the 27-yard line for a first. Brissett sets to throw it. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked up by Minka Fitzpatrick. There he goes, right side. The 20. And he brings this one back. It's a pick six for a Steeler touchdown. What a moment for him, a pick six in the Super Bowl. You think about some of the big pick sixes over the history of this huge game. I remember, because I was watching with a lot of Colts fans, Tracy Porter picking Peyton Manning to get the Saints' first title.
Yeah, that one pretty much sealed the deal for New Orleans as well. But I got to go back a ways because, you know, unfortunately, I'm considerably older. Herb Adderley, the Green Bay Packers, got it all started. The first pick six, Super Bowl II against the Oakland Raiders, and some of the better ones that were out there. You might remember Dwight Smith of the Tampa Bay Buccaneers had 2-1 game when they won their Super Bowl championship against Rich Gannon in Oakland. You mentioned Tracy Porter already. How about James Harrison of the Steelers? You remember that one? 100 yards right before the half ended? That was a big-time play. But for me, the absolute classic, Willie Brown in slow motion against the Vikings for the Raiders. The grand old man, Willie Brown, 75 yards.
You recall him all. What a play here. Another pick six in the Super Bowl. Here comes the Atlanta offense now ready to take over here. And last time, decent field position through the pick six, obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit.
And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off at about the 31. And he brings this one back. It's a pick six for a Steeler touchdown. That pick six extending this lead even further. And boy, it's been a while since I've seen a team struggle this badly in the first half.
I think all they want to do is get to the locker room, try and regroup, and come out to start the third quarter. But if things don't improve fast then, I think the backups get a lot of play in the second half.
Now McManus to tack on the extra point. And the route is on here in this first half. So the defense creating some points, not only getting the interception, but then returning it to the end zone for the pick six. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Now on the return here, we've got an injured player down there. Well, he gets attended to. We'll step aside. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And they gave up the pick six, and now they'll be looking to right the ship here. Now, as a quarterback, are you a little more cautious this go-around?
You should be, just because after what you gave up. But you can't be so cautious as to just really take things in and now you're not going to play loose enough to give your team a chance to score. But you still have to be careful because those defensive guys, I know the reputation defense guys can't catch. All evidence to the contrary on that last possession, though. So many times when we talk about coverage, we're just about a defender running with a receiver. But a big part of it is understanding where the football is, finding it. In this case, when it arrived, it wasn't a surprise, and he was able to bat it away.
Pressure comes, and the Steelers take him down. Stephon Tuitt. That is one he will remember. It's sack number 85 of his great career, moving him past Hall of Famer Howie Long on the all-time list. The Falcons on third down. Just 1 for 5 to this point. This will be third and forever.
To throw is Brissett. And pressure coming, and they got him once again. He could not get away that time, and it'll be a loss of 11 on third down.
How about that, partner? His second sack of the game, and that puts him in some pretty good company. 17 guys have had 2 sacks in the previous 52 Super Bowls, but only 3 have had the record number of 3 sacks in this game.
And we've got the list here. If he gets another one and everyone behaves nicely, we might just list those out for him.
Here's Jamie Gillen now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. Taken right around the 44. A very good return that time. 18 yards. And the Steeler offense, they're set up nicely as they take over. Getting set to go again as we look at the back heading onto the field again. He's been effective so far over the 40-yard mark here in the second quarter. Don't forget about those guys up front, though. They've been effective, too.
The leverage game has been in their favor. They've been the ones who've been able to bend their knees, drop their hips, and get a little bit lower than the guys on the other side of the football, and they've moved them out of the way for the runner.
Sometimes that's tough for those big fellas.
Not an easy thing for them to do.
After the incomplete pass, here now is 2nd and 10. To throw again. Rose hitting Juju on the slant. And he's going to get this inside the 30.
Let's just call it what it is. This has been a flat-out struggle for this defense all game long. They've really had a hard time slowing them down. And while I'm not big on speeches and guys jumping up and down, they might need their team leader on defense to get in their face right now and light a fire under these guys. They've got to start playing better assignment football and start getting guys on the ground.
And he'll work this forward for about 3 at 2nd down. The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. And to give this time to the tailback. And pretty good running as he'll be close to a 1st down at the Falcons' 18-yard line. 52 yards rushing for him now in the first half of this Super Bowl. And the Steelers on 3rd down. No problems to this point. A perfect 5 for 5. They're looking at 3rd in the nose of the football. Open man, Smith-Schuster. It's complete. And he will have a Steelers 1st down, and he'll have it by plenty as they're able to keep the drive alive on 3rd and inches.
But we always hear about the connections some quarterbacks have with certain receivers. I think this guy has a connection with just about everyone. Didn't mind throwing it in there against double coverage to him.
Show some confidence, supreme confidence.
Big time confidence that he would make the play for him, and he did.
They'll run on 1st down. Ball. And he'll be taken down here at about the 11. Just 1 yard on the 1st down carry, so it's 2nd and 9. From the gun, Rose. And it's caught. That was play number 7 on this drive, and it got him 7 yards. 2 minutes on the clock in the 2nd quarter of this Super Bowl. From the gun on 3rd down, Rose. To the goal line, but it's incomplete. Now a field goal forthcoming for the Steelers. From the right hash here, should be an easy one. The kick by McManus is good. And that will just add 3 more to a lead that's already out of hand. So everything else has gone right in this first half. Kind of follows that it would for their kicker, too, as he adds 3 more onto the lead.
Yeah, and the way that this one's gone, definitely not looking like he's going to have to worry too much about pressure kicks late in the game. He can go out there free and easy, just work on his form, and he knocked that one through.
Now we get a peek at the captain of this offense heading back out there. So with the 3 interceptions, how does he erase those from his mind and just focus on this drive?
I think he may need some help from the coaching staff. Maybe the offensive coordinator says, okay, let's do a few of the shorter throws, quick rhythm throws where the ball's out of his hand quickly into a receiver before the defense can react. Maybe not take so many shots downfield, just in case. Get your confidence back up, and then later on, expand the targets again.
The KISS method, keep it simple, stupid. Right?
I love it. I love it.
From the gun, here's Brissett. He's going to dump this off to his running back, Hunt. They're going to need to get up and set in a hurry. Throwing again on second down. Brissett swings this out for Hunt. So back-to-back plays, each get nothing. And they're going to have a third down. They'll look to throw again. And an incomplete pass. That'll stop the clock here with just under a minute to play in half number one. Some of the fans here don't seem too happy about what we've seen in this first half.
No, not at all. And I understand why. They look lethargic, out of sync, and it shows on the scoreboard.
Here's Jamie Gillen now as he's on to punt for Atlanta. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. And did they keep it in? They did. They kept it in. It's down close to the goal line at the one-yard line.
You rarely call your punter a weapon, but he certainly was there. How about that? Pinning him down at the one-yard line and helping out the defense in a big way. I'm telling you what, if I'm a defensive coordinator, I might be thinking safety right now.
First down. It's Ball. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down. On second down. It's Ball. And he'll push forward here for a good little run as the clock continues to run. So we've reached halftime here in the Super Bowl. As we'll get you over to Orlando, where standing by is Jonathan Coachman. He has our EA Sports halftime report.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. What a season this has been. Hard to believe it ends tonight. As we'll get back to you guys for the second half of this Super Bowl in just a moment. Thus far, this Super Bowl has looked less like a contest and more like a coronation. And to call the second half, let's get it right back out to Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Okay, Coach, thanks as always to you and the gang in Orlando as we welcome everyone back in for quarter number three. These two teams sat through a longer than usual 30-minute wait, but we're back in action here in the Super Bowl. No return there for Harris, and the drive will begin at the 25. Here again comes the captain of this offense leading his crew back out there now. And what would you say? Is it the offensive line that has caused a lot of this pressure to get back there?
That's always the first place that you have to look to see what's going on. But part of it is so difficult to simulate this type of pass rush in practice because the speed, the ferocity, the quickness, some of the change-ups and how they get at the quarterback that you may not have seen on film, all that is different. You can practice it as much as you want to. You can even insert smaller, faster guys at positions to show that the speed's going to be quicker. But until the whistle blows and you play for real, it's just not the same.
And not as easy to implement on game day.
To throw again on second down, Brissett. And give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34. On third down, here's Hunt. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage.
Well, they certainly haven't been able to get him going and establish the run, so I think it's time to abandon that plan and start chucking it all over the park. And you know who's excited about that? The defensive front. They got a chance to pin their ears back and get after him now.
Thank you. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Now it's Hunt. And he'll be taken down by the face mask, it appeared. And yes, out come the flags.
Face mask. Defense.
Now they'll get the yardage on the run and get 15 more for good measure.
Yeah, that wasn't too difficult to spot. You heard the sideline erupting, and the flags came out almost immediately.
So the penalty yards marched off on the face mask. Here's first and 10. They'll set up to throw. Short throw caught by Pitts. They'll be brought down on the 30-yard line after a gain of 6. And the ball on the 30. Here's second and 4. Out of the gun, Brissett. And he gets this one to Ridley, complete. Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move, first and 10. Now a give, right side. It's Hunt, and it's been like this all night long. Nowhere to run as they stop him behind the line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
On second and 12, Brissett. Pressure applied, and he's going to be taken down. They sack him back at the 33-yard line. T.J. Watt. It'll go as a loss of about 8 as he gets in there to drop him. Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. He'll look to throw. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And down to the 20 he'll go before heading out of bounds. It'll be a pickup of 13, but it'll still lead to a fourth down.
It's interesting because when I'm watching college football and I'm evaluating guys for the draft now, my list of fullbacks, pure fullbacks, it's a very short list. I'm probably evaluating more punters and kickers now than I am fullbacks, but it doesn't matter what you call the position, it's who you put there, and there we saw a completion.
Blankenship's kick is good. And they'll get back 3, but this remains a large deficit. Surprised by that they kicked the field goal. I guess you get some points, but this deficit third quarter, I don't know.
Yeah, I don't either. Yeah, I'm with you on that one. When you're down that much, kicking a field goal, does it feel a little bit maybe waving the white flag
and just
want to get
that
out of here? Yeah, I think you got to go ahead and try and get some bigger points on the board.
Time for the Steelers offense now to get set for their first possession of half number 2. They'll run on first down. Ball. And give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34. 6 yards on that last play. Here's second and 4. Looking to throw. Rose. Over the middle, complete. That's Williams. Down. Rose. Open man right side is Smith-Schuster, complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Throwing on first down. Rose. He finds his man, complete. It's Sharp. And he is out of bounds inside the 35.
So first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material.
Now they'll run on the draw. A pickup of about 3 yards as he's taken down at the 31.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3 yard gain.
Snap will come from the 31 on second and 7. They'll keep it on the ground. Sharp. A short gain here, maybe a yard to the 29.
Yeah, we dominate today.
They got to get to the 23 here on third. Back to throw. Rose. And inside the 20 before he's brought down.
If anyone thinks they're just going to tuck their horns in and pull back off the throttle a little bit, you can forget it. Even with this big third quarter lead, I think this team's going to continue to take their shots downfield, and there's another completion.
So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Completing it to the right side, Johnson. It's another 10 yards on that one and another first down. On second down now, it's ball. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he's going to take it in for a Steeler touchdown. A great play there. His second touchdown of this Super Bowl. And the Steelers are starting to pour it on the game's biggest stage. They are running away with this Super Bowl. For the extra point. And the lead grows even larger here in the third quarter. So that one a pretty time-consuming 10-play drive, and it results in a 4-yard touchdown run. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And we will not see a run back here from Harris. Atlanta now coming out on the field. They are right now just ice cold. I mean, they have struggled big time in this game, and they're getting blown out. How do they adjust?
So tough, because we always talk about it being a team game, and you need all 11 working well together. But every now and then, partner, you need that one guy who can make a play against all odds that maybe can ignite things. And I think that's what they're looking for right now.
Yeah, you talk about going to your playmakers, they probably need to do it.
Find someone that you're used to touching the football that makes big plays and give them that opportunity to maybe wake up everyone else.
Now a first carry for their fullback. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. Back to throw here. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
It's been clear in this matchup which side has been the more physical one. It's been this defense. And here's another example on that last play.
And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. We saw this a lot in the first half, and it continues. These receivers just not able to get much separation.
So that means they have to win the 50-50 balls. They've got to go up with the defender and find a way to start coming down with them.
And this time, contact and another incomplete pass. And a nice job here on special teams. This will be down inside the 10 at the 8-yard line.
absolutely love the flexibility of these punters. Their leg drive, able to get it way up in the air, and that allows their punt team to get down there and down it inside the 10 because they've had some time.
There he is, the man taking the snaps under center, heading out for the next possession. He has been consistent, hasn't he? He played well in the first quarter, good second quarter, and now continuing that here in the third.
And that's the word that they're always seeking.